Hello everyone. Have you or a loved one been diagnosed with breast cancer? If the answer is yes, then it is essential to know everything about breast cancer. We're here today to help you know everything about breast cancer. We'll take a deeper dive into the topic to answer all your questions about it. I am Ume, and before we start, please subscribe to our channel so the next time you'll be updated with our new releases. So what is breast cancer? According to the World Health Organization, breast cancer is the most frequent cancer among women, impacting 2.1 million women each year, causing the greatest number of cancer-related deaths among women. One in every eight women is at risk of breast cancer at some point in her life. So what is cancer and how people get cancer? The human body is made of trillions of cells. Normally, human cells grow and divide to form new cells as the body needs them and to replace old, aging, damaged cells when they die and shed off. However, cancer is when the cells multiply out of control. Our role today is to answer most of your questions regarding breast cancer. Today we have Dr. Jung, who is a leading doctor at Korea University Anam Hospital in Seoul. He's going to discuss with us about breast cancer from an experienced medical point of view. Hello, Dr. Jung.
Oh, 안녕하십니까.
Nice to meet you.
Hello, I am Seong Pil Young, currently working at Korea University's Anam Hospital Breast Cancer Center.
So Dr. Jung, we're here to talk about breast cancer. What is breast cancer?
I am happy to discuss breast cancer. Cancer is an uncontrolled replication and growth of cells. Breast cancer is a cancer that starts in the breasts.
Dr. Jung, what is benign breast tumor?
Benign breast tumors grow within the breasts and does not spread outside the breasts.
Alright, so what is the most common breast cancer?
The breasts produce milk and ducts exist to deliver the milk. So these two areas often are susceptible to cancers. About 80% or more of breast cancers are ductal carcinomas. Although there are rarer ones, such as the muscle tissues of the breasts.
Okay. Doctor, who is at high risk of breast cancer?
Every woman can get breast cancer. Since breast cancer has many underlying causes, it can start many ways. Early menstrual periods before normal age and starting menopause at a later age can expose women to female hormones longer, raising the risk of getting cancer. Also, female hormone substitutes such as birth control can increase the risk. Also, high-fat diet and obesity due to lack of exercise can increase risk. Aside from these, heredity also plays a factor if someone in your family has a history of breast cancer, or if you carry a gene predisposed to developing breast cancer.
So breast cancer, are there any symptoms for breast cancer?
At the beginning stage, there aren't any apparent symptoms. As the cancer grows, one can feel it through touch, but there is not any pain. Many visit the hospital when the cancer lump grows large. Aside from the growth of lumps, one may exhibit bloodletting through a nipple. In such cases, one must promptly visit the hospital for help. While it is normal for women to leak milk or other liquids, if blood is being let out, it is imperative to visit the hospital. Some show changed in skin.
So, how can a female lower the risk of breast cancer?
Like I said before, since breast cancer can develop from a variety of causes, since one cannot control how soon one starts to menstruate, or how early one starts menopause, it is key to exercise regularly and maintain a healthy body weight. Getting a yearly checkup exam is the way to discover any breast cancer early.
So talking about breast cancer, what is inflammatory breast cancer, or what people know as IBC?
IBC is a breast cancer that even attacks and spreads to the skin. Symptoms include lumps in the breasts and redness on the breast skin, as well as bumpy skin like an orange peel.
So for a lot of breast cancer, people who have breast cancer, they have also pain. What is usually the cause of this pain?
Breast pain is separate from breast cancer. Most females undergo breast pain. Rather than cancer being the cause, it could be from physical pain and muscle aches. So just because there is pain in the breasts, it is not necessarily due to cancer. However, if pain is persistent and the patient has not had an exam for a prolonged period, it is a good idea to get a checkup.
So it's related to hormones as well?
Yes, there is relation to hormones and menstrual cycles. No need to just look at it from a cancer perspective.
Okay. So self-diagnosis, is there anything that the female can do to diagnose if she has breast cancer or not?
Breast cancer self-diagnosis is very important. If breast cancer is detected early, success of recovery rate is 95%. So it is very important to discover early. There are two methods. You can do it yourself or go to the hospital for exams. Self-exam is an easy method to know early. It can be done once a month, right before or right after menstruation, because the breasts are most tender, which makes it easy to detect issues. For those who are pregnant or have menopause, it is best to set a date every month to self-exam. Look in the mirror and see if there are any changes in shape, any inflammation, etc. It can be done with one's hands, but many do it incorrectly. Instead of touching or squeezing with the entire hand, use three fingers like this to see if there are any lumps. Use this technique to check not just the breasts, but the surrounding areas as well. Do this sitting down as well as lying down to get the best results.
Okay, very useful information. How about hospital diagnosis?
If there are no particular issues, a scan every 2 years for those over the age of 40 is recommended in Korea. However, since Asians tend to have smaller breasts, more precision is needed through CT scan. If upon scanning there are issues detected, further tests are recommended. So while the recommendation is once every 2 years, it is even better if done every year.
So what are the kind of treatments, options for a breast cancer patient?
There are many types of treatments for breast cancer. The basic one is surgery, then chemotherapy, hormonal treatments, etc. Should we go over one by one?
All right, let's start with surgery.
As with any cancer, the basic treatment is surgery. If the tumor is small and contained in the breasts, it is best to remove and maintain the original shape of the breasts. Many prefer this, of course, not just the patients, but also the doctors. But if the cancer is large in size or spread over a large area, we must regrettably remove the entire breasts. If the breasts are removed, women experience depression, so we do augmentations with one's own tissue or substitutions. Or we can do it so after the cancer is completely cured after a few years. If we save the breasts and conserve, we must supplement with radiation as we may have missed some tumors, especially if the cancer has been lingering for a prolonged period.
So you talked about radiation therapy. Can you tell us a little bit more about radiation therapy?
Many people misunderstand between chemotherapy and radiation. Radiation therapy is used for treatment of breast cancer. Those who have had preservation cancer must also undergo radiation therapy. And in some extreme cases, total removal is needed. The radiation therapy typically lasts 20 to 40 days. It is relatively simple, and hair loss and throwing up is not normal.
Okay. So last kind of treatment, which is hormonal treatment. Okay, doctor, tell us more about hormonal treatment and any other options.
As we discussed so far, surgery and radiation treatment apply to breast cancer. There are treatments that involve the entire body, as with chemotherapy. With chemotherapy, if we assume that there might be affected cells somewhere in the entire body, sometimes we use it after surgery, or if the cancer is extreme, right from the diagnosis and has spread. Hair loss and throwing up is associated with chemotherapy, but some cases it is necessary. There is also hormonal treatment that blocks the female hormones. In some cancers that have affinity towards female hormones, we use this method to block these hormones. Hormonal treatments, unlike chemotherapy, does not include hair loss or throwing up. However, this treatment induces menopause symptoms such as face sagging or cartilage pain. However, all these types of treatments work well for breast cancers. So whatever treatment is correct for the specific case, it is a good idea to follow through with the prescribed treatments.
Okay, so for breast cancer, is there such a thing as hereditary breast cancer?
Lots of people. If someone in their family has breast cancer, they worry about heredity or genetically predisposed breast cancer. Family heredity does not seem to play a big factor. But some tend to have frequent breast cancer, but that is due to a breast cancer-inducing gene, which should be about 5% of all breast cancer cases. It is not that big. The gene is BRCA. There's a function to fix broken DNA. But that gene that fixes the broken DNA is not working properly, resulting in many types of cancers. Therefore, breast cancer, ovarian cancer, pancreatic cancer, prostate cancer, etc. can occur. Someone with this gene tends to pass on to their offspring about 50% of the time, which can trigger cancer.
So, last question. Does breast cancer affect either pregnancy or breastfeeding?
Oh. Pregnancy and breast cancer do not correlate greatly. The reason is that most pregnancies happen at a young age, where breast cancer is not of high occurrence. In rare cases, there are people who get breast cancer during pregnancy. In this scenario, we can apply various methods to treat. Of course, we need to discuss with the patient in order to preserve the unborn baby. We cannot perform aggressive treatments. But once the baby is bigger, around the 7th or 8th month of pregnancy, we can start treatment. Some chemotherapies can be used without danger to the unborn baby. And surgery is possible too. But chemotherapy can affect the baby. So we do not carry out preservation and radiation. Instead, we carry out removal surgery or begin treatment after the baby is born.
Very clear. I think that's it for today.
You're welcome.
Thank you. The breasts produce milk and ducts exist to deliver milk. So these two areas often are susceptible to cancer. About 80% or more of breast cancers are ductal carcinomas, although there are rarer ones such as the muscle tissues of the breasts. Every woman can get breast cancer. Since breast cancer has many underlying causes, it can start many ways. Early menstrual periods before normal age and starting menopause at a later age can expose women to female hormones longer, raising the risk of getting breast cancer. Also, female hormone substitutes such as birth control can increase risk. Also, high-fat diet and obesity due to the lack of exercise can increase risk. Aside from these, heredity can also play a factor if BRCA gene is present. At the beginning stage, there aren't any apparent symptoms. As the cancer grows, one can feel a true touch, but there is not any pain. Many visit the hospital when the cancer lumps grows larger. Aside from the growth of lumps, one might exhibit bloodletting through a nipple. In such a case, one must promptly visit the hospital for help. Since breast cancer can develop from a variety of causes, since one cannot control how soon one starts to menstruate or how early one starts menopause, it is the key to exercise regularly and maintain a healthy body weight. Getting a yearly checkup exam is the way to discover any breast cancer early. Now, breast cancer self-diagnosis is very important. If breast cancer is detected early, success of recovery rate is 95%. So it is very important to discover early. There are two methods. You can do yourself or go to hospital for exams. As with any cancer, the basic treatment is surgery. If the tumor is small and contained in the breast, it is best to remove and maintain the original shape of the breast. But if the cancer is large in size and or spread over a large area, we must regrettably remove the entire breast. Thank you for joining us in yet another video covering key health-related topics with Cloud Hospital TV. If you have any questions or comments, please leave it below and we'll respond to you as soon as possible.